book out there about how to make pop-up. It's been invented, mm-hmm. but who knew?
Yes.
I remember what you're talking about. The best thing about that is something that I learned or something that came to my head, and it took them time in Hollywood to figure this out way back in the beginning of cartoons, and that is that when you're driving along a road, and if you look out the window, the stuff that's closest to the car is going by, and the stuff that's a little further away is going by like this, and the moon or the sun or whatever doesn't go anywhere. Well, eventually, but you've got to drive a long way. And it stays put. And so when I did this, I had to roll or dolly with certain things held in place and other things staying exactly where the camera was. So the cyclorama, or the thing that has the moon on it, has a long wooden structure that goes under the table the scene is on to the camera, so that the tripod and the ball all roll. And then with a little shaky, you may notice that Japanese earthquake is going on. And it's at least an 11 on the Richter scale. But, you know, the other thing I want to say about this, I find this very painful to watch because it's like looking at your child, you know, that was pulled out of your womb too early when it was born. So it's hard for me to look at. It's not that I didn't love what I intended. It's just that.
And in 64, when you were doing this film, did you have any worries about doing, I mean, you were remarkably open about your sexuality. You were doing, people should know that Jim was doing things like the Blue Blood set in New York would hire Jim to do fundraisers and things like that. And then he'd recycle the costumes in this film using the stuff that they paid for.
Yeah. I did the Junior League Mardi Gras Ball every year, and I was doing it like the hats. There's an Eiffel Tower, not in this movie, but in one of the photographs I did, it's all a sequin Eiffel Tower, and it's something like 9 foot tall. And it's in the background of a shot I did with a patch man, you know, with a pretty boy in front of it. Anyway, and the lamppost. But the Eiffel Tower was like one of those lanterns. It folded up and was inside someone's, it was a skyline of Paris around the brim of the hat, and then as they played da 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 da, the Eiffel Tower rose. Great finger action. Token later, subconsciously.
Yeah, yeah, clearly.
But that's the kind of costumes I did. There were these things where, like, a designer had done My Fair Lady costume thing before for the Junior League Mardi Gras Ball, and one woman came out in the as the flower girl, and then she stepped back, the curtains closed and opened, and then the other girl was standing there in the ball gown. I did the same thing, only she came out as a flower girl and she spun, and when she stopped, the flower girl was gone, and she was in a big theater coat and a beautiful gown underneath it. And that's the kind of thing, because I loved magic when I was a child, I started applying magic trick principles to costumes. So you can turn something inside out or whatever trick you're using, or basis. Those things are all scientific, all the, you know, water levels and stuff. The pitcher thing where you pour the milk out of the pitcher and it, nothing really is pouring out, has all got to do with water levels finding them. So anyway, I applied all that sort of knowledge or whatever, memories to some costumes, so that all the costumes did things or grew or turned into something else. Much like a pop-up. Actually, there was a costume that had sort of pop-up roses. She was like this with the sticks and the drapes hanging down. And it was covered with buds. And then when you let something loose, the buds all fell open and turned into big blooming roses, which then became roses on a cover of a magazine. I'm with a boy. So that's how I recycled. I took the, thank God there were big costumes. Actually, the cyclorama I used for much of the thing before I discovered seamless was a cape that covered the master ballroom floor. That was supposed to be the sea. And that became the sky. You know, stapled up all around the walls of the room. So all those big costumes, they were so big, they could make two sets out of one costume.
Fabulous.
They
you. I just we
don't have any time.
We want to save time for the film, but we also want to thank you for your extraordinary.